Today I'm going to tear down the HTC 10. This will show you the screen replacement, the charging port replacement, battery replacement, and just how much of a royal nightmare this phone is to work on. Buckle up. Turn off the phone and remove both the SIM card tray and the SD card tray. I will link the tools and replacement parts down in the video description right below this video next to the subscribe button. A few things to watch out for. The playing cards or business cards that you're going to use to remove the screen are going to slide over the earpiece. Watch out for the screen ribbons on the left side and the capacitive buttons on the bottom of the device. You'll understand what I'm talking about as you watch. Heat up the phone around the edges, that is where the adhesive is. The phone is totally glued shut, so by heating the edges, you soften the glue. I put a little gap between the screen and the metal frame with my little metal pry tool. Then I slid my business card between the two and into the glue. The thinness of the card will cut the glue and not put any unneeded pressure on the glass. If your screen is already destroyed, you don't need to be as careful as I am, but I want to keep using my phone since it's in good condition. If you put your playing card in too deep, it will damage the super fragile LCD. Basically, if you're going to open your phone for something other than a screen replacement, just plan on replacing the screen as well. It's that fragile. I heat up the screen again about every 20 to 30 seconds. As the glue cools off, it gets hard again. The hotter the glue is, the easier it is to remove it. Pay special attention to the bottom as well, so you don't damage those capacitive buttons. I leave the playing cards all around the edge so that it doesn't re-adhere back to the frame again as it cools. Once the glue is totally separated, the phone will open like a little book. The screen ribbon feeds through the metal midframe into the rear of the phone. All that work and it is still not accessible yet. There are 12 screws around the midframe. This thick midframe is probably what helps give the phone its durability. If you have not yet watched my durability test, you should check it out. This phone is a beast. The midframe is not glued into place, but it is very, very precisely set into the rear of the phone. So using a thin pry tool, pry between the two frames and lift the screen and the motherboard out. This exposes the three different circuit boards stacked on top of each other like some freaky Tetris game. Before we can disconnect the screen, let's unscrew the battery connector and then pop that off so there's no power running through the board. It snaps off like a little Lego. Now listen real quick. If you only need to replace your screen, ignore everything I do until I get to this ribbon cable here. I try to keep as much of the tape intact so that I can reuse it later, but you're much better off just removing it from the phone entirely first and setting it somewhere safe. It'll make this whole project less cluttered. So far, I've removed the power and volume ribbon. There is a little latch that you flip up and the ribbon cable can slide out of its connector. Same thing with the SIM card ribbon. The top board left side connector is the same way. Slide that out after lifting up the different tape layers. The tape is mostly just here to make sure the latches stay latched if you ever drop your phone. Next, I'll remove the charging port ribbon connector and lift off the tape that holds the screen ribbon connector in place. I'll also expose the right side main board ribbon, and the SD ribbon, and the two signal wire connections. Once those are all out, I can remove the copious amounts of tape. This looks like the Medusa of cell phones. There's only one connector for the screen, so if the screen is all you need to replace, don't bother with anything else. It is a nightmare in here, so get out while you can. The screen ribbon slides out through the midframe. So here's the screen. I will link the replacement screens in the video description. Your replacement will look the same as this one, but will probably come with its own adhesive. You'll need to transfer over the home button as well. If you need to do a battery replacement, continue watching. The rest of these screws are going to be a T5 screw from the toolkit that I link in the video description. Let's start with the charging port next, since it is the most likely component to need replacing after the screen, or the battery. You can unsnap the charging port ribbon connector as well as the two wire connectors on either side of it. Then flip the phone over and unstick the capacitive buttons from the midframe. They do have the little LED light attached to it, so make sure not to rip that off. If the light breaks, the button will still function, it just won't light up anymore. Those ribbons will pull through the frame and then release your charging port into the wild. It's got a USB Type-C connector and a microphone on that board as well. Now let's work on the middle board above the battery. It's got one wire connection and then two T5 screws at the top. Grab the little rubber niblet up by the LED flash and the whole middle board can slide out from under the top board. Lift it up gently and watch for the bottom vibrator. For some reason, HTC soldered it onto the main board. It matches the unorganized collection of everything else in here though, so let's just roll with it. The 12 megapixel rear camera is attached to this middle board. It'll unsnap like the little charging port did. Here you can see the OIS image stabilizing on the camera. It will physically move the lens while the camera is on to help stabilize the image, like a little gyro. Thumbs up for how awesome technology is. Now that the middle board is off, we can remove the battery. There are no pull tabs on this one, so we just have to pry it out. Luckily, the screen is not attached anymore, so we don't have to be super careful about flexing that midframe. Just make sure not to flex the battery, and don't puncture it. Also, stay away from that top edge of the battery because there are random ribbon cables underneath it. Here is the 3000 milliamp battery. If you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, I'd love it if you did. It is free. I review technology from the inside. Lift up those two ribbon cables under the battery, and then remove the three T5 screws on the top board. The board will lift off. Here you can see the front 5 megapixel camera with the same OIS image stabilizing feature that the rear camera has. It is a world first to have it on the front facing. The proximity sensor also snaps off like a literal Lego. I think this is a world first as well. Normally they're built into the motherboard. The headphone jack is soldered into place and the front camera is removable as well. The bottom two ribbons are not. One really cool thing about this phone is that both the SIM card tray and the SD card tray are replaceable. Not many phones have that capability lately. Just remove the tape from the midframe and each of the slots will lift out, allowing it to be swapped. The guts of this phone are messy, but at least they are modular. Let's put this bad boy back together. The straighter the ribbons are from the top board, the easier they will be to plug in later. So line those up with the lines underneath the battery. Get those three screws back into place. Always keep your screws organized, even if they look the same. Make sure to lift up the power and volume buttons before you put the battery down. Don't worry, I went back and fixed this later. The camera from the middle board will tuck underneath that top board. Then get the two screws into place. Feed the capacitive buttons through the midframe from that charging port. Make sure they stick, then set the charging port in place. Plug it in along with the two wire connections on either side and the three screws. Now that most of it is in place, we can work on the power button connector and the top ribbon connector, the SIM connector, the wire connector, the SD connector, and the other top ribbon connector. Then I'll tuck the screen through the frame gently. If you kink or bend that ribbon too much, your screen will not work. I'll connect that into place, and then lastly, I can connect the charging port ribbon right on top of it. The last two wires get clipped in. And if your tape still exists, put it back on top. This will just help the latches stay shut when you drop the phone the next time. Get the battery plugged in and screwed down, then set the whole contraption into the rear frame and clip it into place. It'll snap down and you'll hear it. I'll test the screen at this point, get all 12 screws back into place if everything is functioning. The capacitive buttons are working, as well as the screen, so I can hear it down into place. Bonus points to anyone who actually counts how many connections are inside this phone. Well, I'm glad this repair is over. Hopefully with the HTC 11 next year, they'll manage to consolidate a few more components and make the repair more manageable for the average person. Check out the HTC 10 camera test and the durability video. This phone is amazing, as long as you don't ever need to open it up. My Instagram and Twitter are where I am most active. Hope to see you over there. Thanks for watching.